Dr. Chandra Mohan. He is a dynamic young man from Hyderabad, and he is innovating the and training and teaching flexible erotoscopy. And recently, he is the first one to start a laser RIRS. And especially, he has been pioneer in working on a children. And he has the youngest child whom he has done a flexible erotoscopy. Dr. Chandra Mohan, to talk about his experience with the thulium and how the thulium works in the stone management.
Good evening, sir. At the outset, I thank Dr. Mahesh Desha, sir, and MPUH team for giving this opportunity. I'm very happy to be with the esteemed speakers here. With my experience of 1.5 years using thulium fiber laser, I'm giving this talk. The homium laser is no doubt for last 20 years has proven its role in lithotripsy, laser lithotripsy. Now, all the articles what we are seeing now, thulium fiber laser of last 2 years, 2019, 2018, even though research work has been done from 2003, they are comparing with the homium YAG laser. Everybody knows that these two names have come from Swedish. They are basically rare elements, homium and thulium. This is the machine supplied by IPG in India. This slide, everybody is familiar now because last 1 year, majority of the thulium talks is not going to be without this slide. Primarily, it is not YAG laser. It is diode laser. The photons will go into the silica, very small, thin, 10 to 20 micrometer silica, which is delivered outside through a very small, like 50 microns, 100 microns, 150 microns size laser fiber. That is the biggest advantage of this. And everybody asks a simple question, if thulium doped one is a continuous laser, how it works in stone? It is basically electronically modified in a pulsatile manner. Without pulsatile manner, probably it will not work in lithotripsy. The major advantage, second one, is its absorption. Primary, as Khurshid Ghani told, it is a photothermal effect which produces the stone lithotripsy. So water should absorb the energy, become heat, and then make the stone powder. That has maximum efficiency with the thulium fiber laser, that is at 1950 nanometers wavelength. And this is an important slide where we are talking about the homium, the 120 watt Moses effect. Primary mechanism of thulium itself is a cylinder type of the wave. If you see here in the second one, a continuous wave, there it is two bubbles, here it is a continuous wave. That means the maximum efficiency will be delivered to the stone. There is a wide range of pulse energy, frequency, pulse duration we can modulate in this. It is like having 5 gears versus 15-20 gear sports vehicle. Depending on the road, depending on the situation, you can change it. Imagine 0.025 energy is available. Sometimes you don't feel that you are dusting for our eyes. Frequency is going up to 2000 Hz. Normally, we cannot go more than 80 Hz in even 120 watts homium. Pulse duration, even though Khurshid Ghani sir told that long pulse duration is not good, but sometimes if you want to make quickly in a localized calyx, it produces fine dust. The ultimate concept of today, what Dr. Mahesh Desai sir explained, is that if you leave any stone, whether it is an RIRS or PCNL, the chances of regrowth and failure is more. So on the table, if you can see clear with suction, then you have to dust or make particles in such a way that they come out of the suction. This already I have told. See, the laser fiber also is very thin in thulium fiber laser. Now coming to some of the articles which say dusting efficiency is twice that of the homium. Naturally, being homium laser as the gold standard as of now, everything is compared with that. And that reduces the operative time. Retropulsion, 4 times lower than the short pulse mode and 1.8 times lower than the Moses mode. Overall, 28 millimeters per second, it moves initial speed. That's what they say. The same thing is confirmed here, that propulsion is two times less with the this thing. Fiber burn back, honestly, in the last 1.5 year, maybe I might have used around 200, 300 cases. I have not changed and ordered another laser fiber. It really does not burn back because this silica fiber and the laser, thulium fiber laser, their coefficiency is very good and laser does not burn back even though it produces such high temperature. And regarding the 150, 200 micron, whether it will break or not, for example, if you use high energy, sometimes it breaks at the 15 centimeter junction or at the nephroscope entry point. This is important, but the Churan et al. Has told that such type of unsafe is not there with these small laser fibers. Coming to the operating time, as already told, you have to use less energy to break the stone. It forms small vapor bubbles and collateral damage is less. But one important point is it's a coagulative laser also. It is not like homium, which is cutting laser. The 100 million question is temperature rise. Everybody is concerned. Naturally, all our photothermal effects, without rise of temperature, it will not happen. The basic thing what we are doing is the irrigation. If you put a 14 axis sheet, water comes out very fast. If you do supine PCNL, water may come fast. If you have an appropriate size of the nephroscope, water may come fast. In such situations, temperature may not rise. But 5 minutes, if you use continuously, if it's 50 watts, 79 degrees centigrade is reported, which is not good for the body tissues. So irrigation or stop in between, as Purshit Ghani told, is better, especially if you don't have the vision. Here, one more study from Lari and Dragas et al. Tell that there is no difference in the temperature. Now, visibility, definitely if you increase the frequency, particularly in thulium, you lose the vision. If you lose the vision, there is no problem if you are in a calyx where you know the anatomy, especially middle calyx where you don't have much thing to damage there and adequate space is there. But in case of pelvis, in case of impendibula, in case of ureter, you cannot use such high frequency to dust this thing. So safety, majority of the articles as of now are saying that it is very safe. Even in PCNL, they said that 85% success rate and an average time of 23 minutes. And Martov et al. Showed that in mini perk and ultra mini perk papers are also there from Oliver Traxler last few months back. Small stone, they are using thulium. Because the outflow is less, they are telling it is safe. They have taken 8 minutes time to finish. With this, I will show my experience, 4 or 5 videos. See, here I have shown in a bladder stone all settings, how to make the dust and fragments. For example, in bladder, 0.1 and 60. So you don't appreciate even the powder. It at 0.1 to 100, you slightly see what is happening, but really you don't see the, it's almost like water flow. Once you make to 200, you'll make the pieces. Once you make the 200 frequency, see now the pieces size is increasing. For bladder, they may not be very important. For RIRS, they are very important. Once you make 300, large pieces will form. That means even though you can go up to 300, you have to be remembering that in kidney, when you are doing less than 100 or 150 is better. This is at 300. Now, when you increase the energy, more impact, 0.2, 100, it is reasonably good. Small pieces at the same time faster. But once you go to 0.2, suddenly center of the stone breaks. In RIRS, this is not good. Especially in pelvis, it is not at all good. But in PCNL, this may be sucked out the way the Mahesh Deshasar is telling. Your fragment sizes are different with various technologies, but ultimately we have to know which surgery we are doing, where we are located. Inferior calyx, better not to leave any fragments, they grow and they may not be able to suck. In bladder, all these fragments can be sucked with the 18 French R, 22 French nephroscope with just simple Elix evacuator. Now coming to the thulium and homium, you see in a live workshop, we were doing similar type of the stone, one with 0.5 joules and 20 hertz. See the difference. Micro chipping, to my observation, is more clearly observed in homium, whereas in thulium, some amount of vaporization happens. Even we can smell if you do continuously for 5 minutes, the RIRS. So, but at the end, when the fragments are there, the thulium is very fast. If you really want to make powder in RIRS in a calyx, if you keep for 1 minute, the very fast movement of the stones and very fine powder happens. This is beyond doubt proven in the literature that in a localized calyx, you can break the stone faster and go into it. Now coming to the 3 years baby, a supine super pair. Why the reason is large stone. Why I'm telling is that I'm doing pediatric a little more, as Mahesh Deshai sir told. The safety of the this laser in the kidney, for example, whether it is burning the mucosa or not like that, it is a case of a large stone burden. So I have not attempted RIRS. Directly, I have gone for the supine PCNL. This is the picture, which is a very easy case. Then we punctured the inferior calyx. Easy in the sense PCS is dilated. Once you went inside, we have used here suction made by Indian Super Perk, where these small fragments are taken out, but there are no fragmentation. You carefully watch here on the surface, you don't see any fragmentation because this is 100 Hz and 0.5 joules. You are eating away the stone without seeing even powder because every small dust particle is sucked out. When I have shown on the gauge piece, you will see very, very, very fine powder. At the end, when the surface area is same, volume is less, those fragments can be sucked out by the instruments, what Mahesh Deshai sir is telling. But volume is more, they cannot be sucked out. This is about the RIRS in a large stone. What will you do in large stone? Will you dust for a long time and take time? This is a 2 cm upper calicial stone. This is an ideal case for RIRS. You should not spend time. Now you go here, you don't make powder. Liberally you perforate. This is called perforation technique, which in the last Kushit Gani has shown. You perforate purposefully. The retropulsion in the laser fiber and a blast sheet problem is not there in this thing. So you make fragments. One more advantage is once you make 5mm fragments, they float and true popcorn effect causes, and then pop dusting happens. When pop dusting happens, you will produce very, 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 very fine dust. For example, at the end of this, around 10 minutes, 20 minutes, if you can do in upper calyx like this, see, this is the dust at the end we produced. But the only problem is vision, temperature, and continuous outflow. If the stent is not done before, if 14 French is not used, you may injure the mucosa. That studies only will prove. Now, lower calicial stone, what will you do? You cannot do dusting. You cannot see all the stone. In such cases, you put the laser fiber, make it fragments and keep at the low frequency, low energy, so that it will keep on moving and spend time. In such cases, even if it touches the mucosa, it produces only coagulation. Whereas in holmium, it produces a cutting effect. In such cases, you will get bleeding. Any small bleeding in such cases, you have to abandon, and stone-free rate is zero. Last case, ectopic kidney, where an important part is that the anatomy of the ectopic kidney, if you move the stones into small calyces, your SFR will go down. You cannot go into such stones. This is a big stone in the large capacious pelvis. See how much bending is there, and then small laser fiber of 100 microns, if comes, you can do in situ also. See, one small stone is taken back and put it into the major stone. Important thing is it should not move. You should always do the small stone first, because in the midst of the powder, it may not be seen. This small stone is not moving, no retropulsion here. After some time, it moves when the volume is very less. Now I am going to the main stone, and main stone, if you continuously do one layer like in a book, the never decrease the surface area to decrease the retropulsion. These fragments, one more advantage in thulium is that in the pelvis, you can do popcorn localized. Normally, it is difficult with the holmium because it burns and fragments move away very fast. Here, they come. It has suction effect because of the high frequency. So this is a 2 years baby where if you go in a RIRS, large stone burden, like this is the external genitalia, very small baby. Here we are using, because dilatation can be done in the female patient. Now I am going inside, there is, passing the access sheet big. See, there is no vision here, but we know where you are in a calyx. It is very fast. Outflow is very good in the left hand, you can see on the hand. And the suction, the irrigation is done. At the end, you see, calyces are not damaged. Papilla is nicely seen, no thermal damage. You can inspect at the end with good vision, but faster. This is the fine dust produced in 2 years, baby. So with that, this is again same. At the last slide, this can be used again, no conflicts of interest, but this can be used for the enucleation very well, 60 watts. It can do nice. On the right side slide, you can see the bladder tumor, we are sending histopathology separately to see thermal effect, but see the muscle fibers, how nicely it is seen. So with this, we say that it has a good dusting ability, faster dusting ability. Definitely, it will be most promising alternative to homium lag for lithotripsy. And studies are in the early stage, probably in a couple of years, this will be the future. Thank you, my team helping me. Thank you very much. Thank you once again, Mahesh sir, for giving this opportunity to me.